Hey, it's Ernie D, and you're watching Radio Disney's exclusive One Direction performance and interview.
I'm broken, do you hear me? I'm blinded, 'cause you are everything I see. I'm dancing alone. I'm praying that your heart will just turn around. And as I walk up to your door, my head turns to face the floor, 'cause I can't look you in the eyes and say, when he opens his arms and holds you close tonight, you just won't feel right, 'cause I can't love you more than this, yeah. When he lays you down, I might just die inside, you just don't feel right, 'cause I can love you more than this, can love you more than this. If I'm louder, would you see me? Would you lay down in my arms and rescue me? 'Cause we are in the same. Save me, when you leave it's gonna get. And then I see you on the street, in his arms I get weak, my body fails, I'm on my knees praying. When he opens his arms and holds you close tonight, it just won't feel right, 'cause I can love you more than this. When he lays you down, I might just die inside. It just don't feel right, 'cause I can love you more than this. Yeah, I've never had the words to say, but now I'm asking you to stay for a little while inside my arms. And as you close your eyes, you will see the light that's shining from the stars above. And I'll say, when he opens his arms and holds you close tonight, it just won't feel right, 'cause I can't love you more than this.
'Cause I can't love you more than
when
this.
When he lays you down, I might just die inside. It just won't feel right, 'cause I can love you more than this, yeah. When he opens his arms and holds you close tonight, it just don't feel right, 'cause I can love you more than this. When he lays you down, I might just die inside. It just don't feel right, 'cause I can love you more than this.
Let's take some questions from the fans. You guys ready to do this? Abigail, are you there?
Mm-hmm.
Are you there? Say hi to One Direction.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Abigail, what's your question?
What's the craziest thing a fan has ever done?
What's the craziest thing?
A few weeks ago, we were in Sweden, and a fan had got past security a little bit, and she kind of hid in a bin, which is a trash can over here.
Or a trash bin.
She hid in a trash bin trash can for like an hour or so, and then they found her, didn't they? I think Andy found her in the end.
Was she waiting for you guys to come out, or
I think so.
Did she smell?
Because we kept running off.
We didn't actually smell her, but I assume if you've been in a bin for an hour, you're gonna have
you would smell your security trash can.
A unique stench.
Yeah. Speaking of your security, they're guys that take care of you wherever you go, make sure you're safe all the time. Is there anything that you guys do that kind of, you know, irks them a little bit?
Well, when we're in the same place, we actually climbed climbed a balcony and escaped the back garden of the place because we hadn't been outside for like a week. Yeah. So me and Louis were like, right, forget this. So we just went out at night and just climbed a balcony and just like escaped.
So what goes through your mind though? You're just gonna do this to have fun?
Just for a little bit of fun.
Break out the studio.
See how far you can get, really.
A tour manager's just behind saying that we ruin his life.
Yeah, we definitely don't make their jobs easy, but...
Nope.
Last night, for instance, Harry just runs right into the crowd and the security are freaking out. Everyone's going to...
Like during shows, that happens too, I would assume.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun though.
Yeah, we like to like tease the security and pretend we're going to go off, and then they're like...
Yeah, no, we actually get on really well with our security team. Like, they travel around with us all the time, so we've been with them for ages, but...
Look at him. He's taking notes right now.
Sometimes they get little hats and stuff awesome. On them in shows.
And that's how we're going to end this One Direction takeover. Guys, thank you so much.
Thank you.